This is for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Looking for new energies. And like I said, I always look for a positive reading, but, you know, we got to give an honest reading. So this is for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising for this week, or for, yeah, for this week coming up, mostly for maybe a couple weeks. For Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. New energies, positive energies for Cancer. And the reason why I'm shuffling the cards like this is because I don't want to bend them. I don't want to bend them all up. They do bend. But I'm always ask for new energy, and I always look for a positive energy. But like I said, we don't get one. We work through it, okay? The Lovers. Cancer could be dealing with a lover situation or partnerships in some way. Incoming energy. Past. Ten of Cups. In the past, you had something you really liked and enjoyed that gave you emotional contentment with the Ten of Cups. But the obstacle is you feel like you don't have a whole lot of money or stability or independence. Current environment, the Seven of Cups. You may be very particular what you let in your life. You don't like confusion, and you may turn a lot of offers and options down for you, Cancer. It may have to do with lovers, you know. What is coming towards you, Cancer, is a Mother of Cups. I don't think it's your energy, because it's coming towards you. Even, well, the outside environment causes, it could be another water sign or mother type figure also. It also could be emotions are all over the place, okay? Now, you see that's outside environment or what's causing all this. In the end, you got the Naked Heart. You're not following your heart. It says to follow your heart. You're supposed to follow your heart, and you haven't been doing that for some reason. I do. Maybe you're thinking about the past a little bit. Maybe you're thinking about a lover. Maybe you want to follow a lover or a certain person, but maybe you, for some reason you're looking for different things. But I'll find out what that is. It definitely has something to do with a lover situation. I will be giving a mini love reading. You know, pick a card, love reading. But let me clarify these. Got the Ten of Cups. Something made you happy. You know, something was in the past that made you happy. Maybe with a love or a emotional situation. So I need two cards for the Ten of Cups, please, for Cancer. Or, you know, starting now, around the 24th. 25th, maybe the 23rd, you know, this right now. I need two cards, please, for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising. Ten of Earth. You had things that you wanted before. Someone's offering you something. I feel like someone wants to offer you something or had at one time. But maybe it's not what you were wanting. Or maybe it wasn't exactly what you planned. Or maybe something is getting in the way. Or maybe, like I said, there's something else you're wanting. Maybe you're a little undecided in some way. But the obstacle is the Nine of Pentacles is about the independence. I'm feeling like somebody may want a commitment with you. But you don't know if you want to do that. So the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. I need two cards for Cancer. Queen of Air, it could be an air sign, air, water, or earth, or something that's not, you don't think is going to be emotionally stable or financially stable for you, I should say. And you, it's like you think it's going to cost you too much of your life. It could cost money, but I'm feeling independence. Current environment, you don't know if you want what is being offered to you. You may think it's confusing what someone has offered to you. You may be confused, you know, and you know, of a love situation. So the Seven of Cups in reverse. I need two cards, please, for Cancer. The High Priestess. You're not sure, you don't trust your intuition, or you're afraid that your intuition may be wrong, or your decisions. Page of Earth could have to do with a Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo, or the messages you're receiving, you don't know if they're for you. And it could be vice versa, you know, where you offer this to somebody and they're not sure. But I do see that it's like in a trust in yourself or trusting in a situation, or the emotions are kind of off for some reason. It could be that something is causing you a little uncertainty to where you want to go in life, you know? So the Mother of Cups in reverse, and this is basically a Cancer energy, as what's causing all this, or the outside environment coming towards you. But could it be that your emotions, something may cause your emotions to go, you know, to tug your heartstrings in some way? So the Mother of Cups, I need two cards, please, for Cancer. Two cards, please. Five of fire. Six of Earth. Yeah, I think someone wants a little give and take from you. They want you to work with them a little bit on a situation. But you're like, don't know if you want to do it with the Five of Fire. It may cause a little bit of arguments. You may be afraid of the arguments. You may be afraid if you tell them something that it may cause an argument. Because I do see someone making you offers, you know, and you're unsure of them. You may be getting a possible suitor that's coming in that wants to, you know, have a relationship with some way with you, you know, in some way, and you may not be sure of it. It does say that you're not going to follow your heart, though, for some reason. For some of you, you know, maybe may feel that maybe it's not where you want to go with this person, for some of you. But it could be that life is getting in the way where you feel like you can't give your heart to this person. But it's like you're holding back, okay, Cancer, on something for some reason. It'll be different for everybody. If I have the comments open, you can leave it in the comments. But I need two cards for the Naked Heart. This is the Naked Heart deck, and this is the eighth House Tarot. But I need two cards. Why you may be holding back? I do see you getting a lot of offers, but it's like Four of Earth in reverse. Page of Water, you're going to turn something down. You're not sure of something. Someone's going to offer you a love situation. They're going to offer you the world. But it's like, and like I said, it could be vice versa. But I'm thinking someone's going to offer it to you, Cancer. And you're going to be like, well, I don't know if I can do this right now. I don't know if this is what I want. I don't know if this is my destiny. This is, you know, I may have to think about it. It may cause a little bit of argument. Someone's saying, well, just, you know, see it my way. They're going to tell you that. See it my way. This is in the future. Okay. Knight of Earth, you're dealing with some people here. Knight of Earth is in reverse. Someone's going to be really kind of, you know, upset over it that you're dealing with. They want you to go towards them. They want to bring stability towards you, but you don't know if it's for you. You don't know if it'll bring you what you're wanting. You got someone coming in that really admires you. It's up to you, though, whether you take it. Let me give you a love reading. Pick a card, love reading. Even though I feel this has a lot to do with something of the emotional nature, that's for sure. So, three cards for Cancer. Pick a card, love reading. For Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Starting to stick a little. This is for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. I'm looking for new energies, and I hope positive energies. When it comes to love, starting around, I don't know, 24th. Oops. There's something better. You may be feeling that. There's something better, and it may be. For Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. That's what that card said. There's something better. And if you're the one that's wanting to give your heart to somebody, it's saying there's something better down the line, you know. Let me pick three cards for the Morgan Greer. Very, very accurate deck for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising concerning love. We need to know about love starting right now. Energies need to come in right now for love. Three cards from the astrological cards for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising about love for September 24th or starting now. I say, I like to say start now because you never know when someone will see this. And I'll go ahead and pull a twin flame if some of you are dealing with a twin flame. If you're not, then disregard it. This is for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. So September 24th, 2020. Bad love. See what's going on. I do feel like someone wants to give their heart to somebody and the other person is unsure. It's up to you. It's up to you. You can take this on and be positive for you. Or you can do something else. It looks like, you know, if you pick this section, I should have told you that. If you pick this section, this is what's going on. But I do bring them all together, as you know, together at the end for secondary energies. It looks like you're going to be taking a leap of faith towards something. Something new, okay? This says look at the bigger picture. And you'll see why you're feeling the way you're feeling. Because it looks like you're afraid about what direction to take for some of you. Or you're unsure if you're doing the right thing. But it says look at the bigger picture and you will see that you're doing the right thing. And if you're dealing with a twin flame, they're constantly looking at your picture. They're constantly looking at your Facebook and stuff. You know, your profile. And here it says, you pick this section or this cards or these cards. Let go. Let go of things that no longer serve you. Or let go of negativity. It could be all those things. And you will gain a victory, a sure victory, if you let things go that are weighing on your heart, you know. And a new romantic cycle will begin for you. And if you're dealing with a twin flame, they're thinking you're all they ever wanted, okay. For some of you, I think someone really has it, you know, for you big time. But like I said, just be assertive in your love life. Be assertive where you want to go. Move passionately forward in a new beginning. You will get a passionate new beginning. Work through your fears. Some of you may be having fears. That's why I'm seeing all this, where you're unsure. Are you making the right decision? And people making you these offers. Work through the fears and it'll get better. You'll get a passionate new beginning. If you're dealing with a twin flame, they still remember the good times they shared with you. And I do see good times in the past if you're dealing with the twin flame situation. Bringing them all together, it's up to you where you want to go. You can go either with this person, and you probably will be happy, or you could follow a different path that you're wanting to go. I do feel like a lot of you are going to take a leap of faith in either way, and it'll pan out for you. Look at the bigger picture. Wherever you want to go, it'll work out. You'll see it more clearly soon if you look at the whole thing. And then you won't be so divided where you want to go in life, okay? Like I said, they're looking at you all the time. They're looking at your Facebook. They think you're gorgeous, okay? They think you're all that, you know, whether you believe it or not. It says let go of the uncertainties in life. Let go of things that hold you back in some way. And you will gain a victory in whatever you decide to do. A new romantic cycle will begin for Cancer, and realize you are all I ever wanted. I'm starting to get a message. You can't see it, but I'm getting distracted and I don't want to. And like I said, be assertive. You're getting a passionate new beginning. Work through your fears. And like I said, your twin flame is definitely remembering the good times, and they're all you ever wanted. This person really does like you. They look at you all the time, your pictures, your Facebook, your whatever you got, Instagram, it don't matter. But I do see you being a little bit torn, but don't worry, it'll work itself out whichever way you turn. It really will. You'll get that overall contentment in what you're wanting in life. You really will gain a victory. So let go of the fears. Work through the fears, because a new romantic cycle is going to begin whichever way you turn, okay? There is going to be a passionate new beginning. So be assertive. Don't hold back. And follow your heart, okay? I'm going to let this go. Talk to you later. Till next time. Bye.